Welcome back. In the previous video, we found the angle, the new angle the ladder makes with the ground, and we were able to find out that that is 27.8 degrees. We are now going to find the distance the foot of the ladder slipped back from its original position. So the foot of the ladder used to be at B. Because it slipped back, it came to A. So we are going to find the distance between A and B. Okay, so we can say that we are looking for this distance from A to B. That is what we are interested in. We are looking for the distance A, B. Okay, so if we draw this right angle triangle here for the triangle A, E, C. So for triangle A, E, C. You can see that AB is in AEC. Now, before we can find AB, if we're able to find AC, then we find BC, and we subtract BC from AC, we can find AB. This is what I mean. From A to C, if you're able to find it, and we find BC, that is from B to C, we can subtract BC from AC, and that will give us AB. Okay, so considering this triangle AEC, we know that AE is 10 meters, and we also know that EC is 4.66 meters. So we can find AC from that from this triangle. Applying the Pythagoras theorem on this triangle, we will have AE squared is equal to EC squared plus the side we are looking for, which is AC squared. AE is 10 meters, so 10 squared is equal to 4.66 squared plus AC squared. You simplify this and you are going to have 78.2844 is equal to AC squared. You take square root of both sides and you are having 8.85 meters. So AC, if you find this and you correct your answer to three significant figures, just as the question told us to do, AC will give you 8.85 meters. So we now have AC. Let's go ahead and find BC. To find BC, I'm going to draw this simple right angle triangle for the triangle BFC. So for BFC, you know that this is the 60 degrees angle. Here is our right angle, that is from point C. From B to F is 10 meters. Then from F to C will be 4 meters plus 4.66 meters, which will give us 8.66 meters. Because from F to C will be 4 meters plus 4.66 meters. So FC is 8.66 meters. So if you apply the Pythagoras theorem on this right angle triangle, you will see that BF squared is equal to FC squared plus BC squared. So BF is 10 meters. So 10 squared is equal to 8.66 squared plus BC squared. Okay, we simplify this and we are going to have 25.0044 is equal to BC squared. You take square root of both sides, and BC will give us 5.00 meters. You correct your answer to three significant figures, so 5.00 meters. So we now have AC. We also have BC. We can see from this diagram that moving from A to C, or length AC, is equal to length AB plus length BC. We have AC and we have BC. So we will say that 8.85 meters is equal to AB, which we are looking for, plus BC, which is 5.00 meters. So you simplify this, you have 8.85 meters minus, sorry, so this is supposed to be in meters. This is in meters. Okay, so meters. So you have 8.85 meters minus 5.00 meters equal to AB. So AB will give us 3.85 3.85 meters. So we can say that the ladder slipped 3.85 meters back from its original position. So from the diagram here, we can see that at the top here, the ladder slipped 4 meters, but at the foot of the ladder, it slipped back 3.85 meters. So using the Pythagoras theorem and the trig ratios also, we have been able to find the distance the ladder slipped back from its original position on the ground. Thank you for watching this video. I hope this video was helpful. If it was, don't forget to like and subscribe. In the next video, we are going to learn how to apply the trigonometric ratios and the Pythagoras theorem to solve questions on angles of elevation and angles of depression. Bye-bye.